So we're back, and we're looking at spoilers here at Ravnica Legion spoilers. So I thought I'd go through everything and everything that's been spoiled so far and explain my thoughts on them. First, we have this is from the ordered from the most recently released, or I mean recently spoiled, to the ones that've been out for the longest. So let's have a look at the first one. Persistent Petitioners. Target player puts a top card of their library into the graveyard. Tap four untapped advisors. Target player puts top 12 cards of their library into their graveyard. A deck can have any number of cards named Persistent Petitioners. So I think this is a quite a strong effect that you can tap four advisors and mill 12. I actually think this might be hard for some decks to deal with. The problem, I guess, with this is you need to have four out and you're very vulnerable to removal if that happens. So I don't know how you could build around this, if you could somehow incorporate this into your list. The effect is very strong, and the fact that you can have any number adds a lot of flexibility, I think, to the card. But overall, I think it might be gi too gimmicky to actually work. I think the mill cards that we have already in standard are better, would be my guess. Next, Collision Colossus. Deals 6 damage to target creature with flying. Remember, you can do this card, of course, if you only have access to green. You probably wouldn't, but you can. And target creature gets +4/+2, gains trample until end of turn. That's quite a big buff. And since you gain trample, it might be relevant. And we have a lot of Drake decks, so it's not a card I would discount necessarily, but it really depends on how the coming Gruul lists are going to look. I think this might be included. I don't know in what numbers, maybe a one-off, maybe a two-off in standard, if it's played at all. I'm not going, by the way, I'm not going to comment like how good is this in limited or how good in this in commander, because I don't play those formats. I don't really never really have and never really cared. So I played a little bit of commander, but never really got hooked. Then we got this card, which says counter target activated ability or triggered ability, or that's for either green or blue mana in any combination, but you need two mana. And replicate one green, one blue, one colorless. Create a token that's a copy of a creature you control. Now I'm thinking, what abilities would you want to counter? There are a couple. There are a couple of planeswalker abilities that you could counter. You could counter the put on top from Teferi. You could counter. You could counter the what's called black. Oh, the Eldest Reborn, of course. That's a possible counter for this. Yeah, what other abilities are there that you can't play? It has to be something that you can't play, again and again and again, like a Niv-Mizzet. I mean, if you counter him dealing one damage, he's just dealing one other damage, so it doesn't matter. Transform? No. It has to be something that you're using with yourself. No, I don't see. Maybe there's an interaction for this where you can counter something like. And I remember it has been in the past that if you count some creatures have very negative effects, and if we see something like that, like a very powerful creature with a negative effect when it comes into play, I don't think you want to play this necessarily. Even create a token that's a copy of a creature you control. Like, we have better cards for that already, so it has to, I think, if this is to be played in standard, then this has to be relevant. It can't just be this, because we already have better cards for, cloning our creatures. So, in standard right now, I can't come up with anything that you would want to use this on in your own deck. So it has to be something they haven't spoiled yet for this to be relevant. Otherwise, I think in older formats, maybe in some sideboards or something, I guess. Next card, Sunder Shaman. Two red, two green. Sunder Shaman can't be blocked by more than one creature. When Sunder Shaman deals combat damage to a player, destroy target artifact or enchantment that player controls. That's decent body. 5/5. Can't be blocked by more than one creature. Usually you want them to block with. You have to block it with more than one creature. Would have been better. A menace would have been better, I think. But whenever Sunder Shaman deals combat damage to a player, destroy target artifact or enchantment. So I guess this is in some way to counter the, Jeskai control, which plays a lot of artifacts, no, artifacts, enchantment, which traps your creatures to avoid that, I guess. It's a decent body. I wouldn't discount this necessarily. It's a depends on if there's really a reason for running a lot of artifact and enchantment removal, because this does does this effect repeatedly, but otherwise, no, not seeing it really. Biogenic Ooze. Whenever Biogenic Ooze enters the battlefield, excuse me, create 2/2 green ooze creature tokens. Nay, create a 2/2 green ooze creature token. At the beginning of your upkeep, put a +1/+1 counter on each ooze you control. You can pay one colorless, three green, create a 2/2 green ooze. So here we have to think a little bit. When it comes into play, you get a 2/2 token. Beginning of your end step, put a +1/+1 counter on each ooze token. So when you play this out, you'll get a 2/2, so you'll have two 2/2s. Then your ooze token will get bigger than the biogenic ooze, so you'll have 5 power on the board, which is decent, absolutely. Problem is they are both very easy to kill. If you do the shock test, does this die to shock? Yes, it does die to shock. It leaves something behind though, so that's something you got going for it. But if you imagine your opponent having an removal to this, so that you don't even get your end step and plus put a +1/+1 counter, I think this, in most cases, this will just be worse than just a history of Benalia. It's what I think. History of Benalia pumps your creatures. It produces 2/2s. It's harder to remove. It's an enchantment. Yeah. I don't see this not getting killed. If you can find some way of not getting this killed, of course, then it's a very strong effect, but probably not gonna happen. Captive Audience is the next card. Captive Audience enters the battlefield under the control of an opponent of your choice. At the beginning of your upkeep, choose one that hasn't been chosen. That hasn't been chosen. Ah, okay, so in this game, I guess. So your life total becomes 4, but what happens when you've chosen all of them? It's an impossible task. Your life total becomes 4. Discard your hand. Each opponent creates 5 2/2 black zombie creature tokens. Okay, so your opponent is going to take the one which is most favorable for them in every case. So let's say you play this versus an aggressive deck. First of all, they're not gonna have any cards left at 7 mana. So the first one is just discard your hand, okay, I did nothing. So it comes into play, it does nothing. Next turn, he'll be forced to give his opponent 5 tutus. Probably doesn't want that if he's an aggro deck, so he's probably going to set his life total to 4. Since he's an aggro deck, he's probably going to be winning on board as well, so that doesn't matter. So it takes 3 turns before you get a good effect from this. The only way I can see this being played is if he cheated into play. There is a put a historic card onto the battlefield. I think this is probably meant to be spicy in some kind of commander deck or something. I don't think this is even aimed for standard at 7 mana. I simply don't see it. Tome of the Guild Pact. Whenever you cast a multicolored spell, draw a card. Add 1 mana of any color. Add 1 mana of any color. Multicolored spell. Yeah. I guess this is made for a control deck, since you wouldn't want to run this in an aggro deck. So it's probably not creatures we're talking about here, it's actual spells. So we think about the spells that we might want to cast. There's Discovery Dispersal, it's a possible spell that we might want to cast that's multicolored. There's things in Golgari that I guess we could draw cards from. But I think the effect is too weak if you're not comboing this. If you can find a combo with this, then it's useful. Otherwise, I would say that it's trash, unfortunately. You play this, it doesn't do anything. Next turn, you're starting a new first card you play and you get one back and you're... I don't see it. I don't see it unless there's a combo. That's true for everything, I guess. Incubation Druid. One colorless, one green. Add 1 mana of any type that a land you control could produce. Okay. If Incubation Druid has a +1/+1 counter on it, add 3 mana of that type instead. Am I the only one thinking graft and modern with this? There's, for you who've only played standard, there's a mechanic in modern and legacy, I guess. It's a card, it's a green card, I think. It's a land, maybe it comes into play tapped, I don't remember. But if you have it out and you play a creature, then that creature enters the battlefield with a +1/+1 counter. That would be a super easy way to get a +1/+1 counter on this insanely fast. In standard though, how many ways do I have to put +1/+1 counters and stuff? There are things coming in this set though. I guess Gird for Battle, we don't want this necessarily in an aggressive strategy. There's the blue-green enchantment, which puts a... That's kind of a crappy enchantment, though. But the effect is so strong. It's so strong that it will be abused. Yeah, this is a good card. I just... If it's only played in... It's either only played in Legacy and Modern, but it's going to be played somewhere, this card. The effect is just too strong. Adding 3 mana... No, turning this into a Eternal Black Lotus is just, yeah, it's just too strong. This will be played. I can't see the exact combo now, but we'll see something. Priest of Forgotten Gods. Sacrifice 2 other creatures. Any number, okay, other creatures, can't sacrifice itself. Any number of target players each lose 2 life and sacrifice a creature. You add 2 black mana and draw a card. Okay, so we have to think, how much are we losing here? We're losing 2 creatures. My guess would be that we're sacrificing some kind of tokens, or things that has afterlife anyway, or things that get bigger when they're sacrificed. So That's not really a problem for if you build a deck around it. Any number of target players. Any number of target players. Yeah, okay. I guess EDH or some commander. Each of those target players. Each lose 2 life and sacrifice a creature. That's really strong. Okay, so you're sacrificing 2 things that we don't need in a deck where we can do that. An opponent loses 1, so it's already, you know, up 1. You add 2 black, that's insanely good. I don't know which one is best, add 2 black or draw a card, but this fact that you get both there. So it's a double whammy here. You sacrifice 2 things, and so it's like a 2-for-2 in a sense, because you're sacrificing 2 things and you're gaining 2 things. You're gaining him losing a creature and you're gaining you drawing a card. But you're also gaining tempo with 2 black, and it's you sacrificing, so it's an insanely strong effect. This is another card when I'm immediately thinking other formats than standard, which this might be played in for insane comboing. But if we try to limit ourselves to standard here, sacrifice 2 other creatures. Which creatures would you want? There's a couple. You could use like resembling skeletons, but then you're wasting too much mana. It would need to be something like Doom Dissenter, maybe, and some tokens. Maybe? It's such a strong effect though, but it comes down at 2, so you probably want to play something out at 1. Okay, so probably what you want to do is play something down at 1, which you can sacrifice. Play this. Then at 3, you need something else that you can sacrifice to this. What would that be? At 3 mana. 3 mana. There's not too much you want to sacrifice. I think we'll have to keep an eye out for any good afterlife creatures that this might... Maybe there's a creature which is kind of crap, but when you afterlife it, it turns into maybe 2 tokens or something. Something like that is what you need, I think, for this card. Yeah, definitely a insanely strong card. One of these two of the best cards spoiled, I think, that I've seen so far. Hero of Precinct 1. I don't even know what Precinct 1 means. Whenever you cast a multicolored spell, create a 1/1 white human creature token. Okay, so we've seen these kinds of effects before, and they've all gone into legacy decks and become really, really strong. But multicolored, if we think about it historically, has always been a tad weak. It's always been difficult to play multicolored spell, but of course it depends on what multicolored spells that you might even want to play. The effect is strong. It's easy to... Everyone's playing sweepers nowadays, so 1/1s in standard. I'm thinking more legacy formats for this, even though it will surely be played in standard. I'm sure someone will come up with a list for this. This is a good card. Maybe I should just leave it at that. It's a good card. It will be played. Maybe it will be played in Legacy. We'll see. But multicolored is much weaker. We've seen the, you know, play whenever you play an instant or sorcery. That's much easier than playing multicolored. Lumbering Battlement. Vigilance. When Lumbering Battlement enters the battlefield, exile any number of other non-token creatures you control until it leaves the battlefield. Doesn't have flash, that's vigilance, okay? Lumbering Battlement gets +2/+2 for each card exiled with it. So what would you want to exile? Of course, the obvious combo, I guess, is to get a lot of enters the battlefield triggers with this. Or tokens, I guess, but it doesn't have trample, so it will just be chump blocked. So the only option left, it's really problematic that it doesn't have any good evasion. Just has vigilance. But the effect is strong. Exile any number on... if you could just replace vigilance with anything else, even flash would have been real good. Like someone targets your creature and like bam, save the creature, gets back, sacrifice this, probably in some kind of comes into play effects and sacrifice effects, so that you can like play stuff out in the early turns, then like drop the lumbering battlement and then like have a sac outlet for this whenever you whenever you don't need it, because it's really, oh, can't use it to tokens, yeah, but it's really bad if if someone puts something like can't attack or something on this, and like some kind of effect that holds this down in some way. I guess they're not that played in standard, but any effect like that, and you wasted all the creatures under it. You really want some way of some. You probably want your creatures back at some point, is what I'm trying to say, because you want them to trigger. So you want some kind of sac outlet. I will definitely keep an eye out for this. I think it's a strong effect, but it's on a horribly clunky body to get something done with. 5 mana, it's, if it would have been 4, that would have been great. 5 mana is a stretch. I don't even know. I don't even know what you would... Yeah. Yep. We'll move on for a while, I think. Here we've got some Korean. Let's see what the Korean card says. Scorchmark deals 2 damage to target creature. If that creature would die this turn, exile it instead. When would this be useful? There are a couple of creatures which you where you want this to happen, but there's already much better creatures. There's like the deal 4 damage. Like, why would you... probably limited or something is what they thought of for this. Orzhov Imposter. Death Touch, Afterlife 1. 1-2. Okay. Doesn't die to Chain Whirler or Plague Mirror or... I don't know. Death Touch, Afterlife 1. It's decent, actually. It's not super good, but like it can... If you want a defensive creature that you're not afraid to sweep the board over, you can put this down. It can kill off a creature, and your opponent is very... Like, he doesn't want to attack into this, because then he's just giving you value. So, yeah, it's a decent card. Wonder what deck will play it. Sure, some deck will actually play this card. It's good enough to be played.